White Sox.
Let's go, 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 White Sox.
I believe that's the late, great Captain Stubby. With a little help from Charles Homer Bill, we welcome to the program Mike North. You hear his show Sunday nights at 9. Hello, Mike.
What's up, guys? What's going on? Stubby. Captain Stubby. Look out for him.
Captain Stubby and Charles Homer Bill.
Hello.
Let's start, before we get to the Bears, let's start with the White Sox.
Yep.
After being a longtime White Sox fan and looking at what Robin has done with this team, can they go all the way?
Yeah, they could go all the way, but, you know, I don't know how long he can bat Adam Dunn third. As you get into September, John, I noticed yesterday he batted third. He went 0-for-4. He's hitting .205. It's nice when he hits the home runs, but I don't know if you can get carried through September in the pennant race with him batting third and hitting .200. If he doesn't hit a home run, it's a strikeout. So, you know what? Good pitching beats good hitting when you get into the playoffs. But as, you know, as I've been looking, Detroit doesn't want it. It doesn't seem like they want it. The teams in the division, don't forget, even if they were to drop to second, they'd be eligible for the wild card. So they're looking really, really good. They're pitching well right now. And Ventura's been a calming influence. And the big deal today is, in my eyes, is Alex Rios. I mean, Alex Rios is a guy that, I mean, last year, I mean, couldn't get out of his own way. You didn't think, you know, he'd be back this year. They put $20 million a year. He was getting paid. He still is. And now, I mean, the other day, it's a home run in the bottom of the 10th. He's had some big, big hits. He's hitting 300. He's the quiet guy right now that's getting it done for them.
All right, let's move on to the Bears. I know they have the preseason game on Thursday, but Brian Urlacher, he's missed his fifth straight practice yesterday, and do you know what's going on? It said it was a personal matter.
Well, I mean, with Brian, I'm sure that, you know, when you're Brian Urlacher, and if you've, in the past, he's had some issues. When you hear personal matter with Brian Urlacher, now you're wondering what's going on, because he's had some situations where, you know, he's had his stuff in public. And you know what? Personal matter for 5 days. Now, I don't want to speculate or anything. I'm sure he's okay when he comes back. I mean, to me, he's gotten better over the last 2-3 years. I was against him signing his last deal, and all he's done is become, as he's gotten older, a better football player. I thought when he was younger, he had a lot to learn. He had played safety in college. He became a pretty good linebacker. But now he's really hunkered down the last 2-3 years, and they're playing better football. So hopefully he'll get back and anchor the middle. I mean, their defense is getting a little aged, if you will. You got Tillman. You got Briggs. You got Urlacher. Your main guys are starting to get into their 32, 33, 34-year-old area. There, for football players, usually that's not good. But, hey, it's all about health. If Cutler goes down like last year, Forte goes down, you're not winning. If you can keep your health, if the Bears can, they got a very good opportunity this year.
What about Johnny Knox? God, I was there. I watched that hit. It made me sick to my stomach.
Yeah, I mean,
is he going to come back? That was the nastiest hit I've ever seen.
Yeah, you know what, Amy, and that's what happens. I mean, and you don't want to hurt your own guys. You don't want your guys going down. But there's hits in every camp. I mean, yesterday I heard at Jet Camp there was a fight between 20 football players. It's the dog days of July and August. They're tired of hitting each other. It usually happens around this time where you open up the paper. It says this team brawled, 8 guys, 2 linemen go on it, added on this team. So, you know, it's getting down to that. Johnny Knox has been hit like that before. He's a little guy, and, yeah, absolutely. You don't want to see that happen, but it does.
Any word from your sources on Philadelphia's coach's son?
Well, the fact is, I mean, I guess they're down about it, but this was predictable. I mean,
What did he die of?
I mean, this guy was arrested in 2007 for heroin trafficking. We're talking about Garrett Reed, the 29-year-old coach. This guy's been in trouble before. He injured another driver when he was on heroin driving a car. He's had problems. They had a room at their house, and you know, Andy Reed. I got to address this. Andy Reed's son dies. And he says, the first thing he says is, I don't want to leave the team. Now, his son was there, but he says, I really don't want to leave the team. That may be the problem. Your son dies and you're worried about the Philadelphia Eagles and in the first week of preseason. Football coaches, 24-7, Andy Reid, one of these guys, a little bit more attention to detail with your kids, because they've had nothing but trouble with them. It's from 2007 on.
Mike, I enjoy reading you in the Daily
Herald. Thanks, guys.
Thank you very much for joining us, and we'll listen Sunday night, okay?
All right. Take care, Amy. Take care, John.
Mike North, also go to 560WIND.com. Take a look at his daily 30 and 5 video commentaries.